गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। Hello, welcome all the learners of Odisha State of University. So today we are having with us Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra, and today we'll be speaking on civil society and social movement in the Indian context. This is a unit from Indian Democracy and Development. And as you know, Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra is teaching in the Department of Political Science and Public Administration in Sambalpur University. So there is no need of introduction to him. He's like He's so active and he's been involving with us since last 20 or 25 days with us, and giving his lecture on different topic, on different aspect of Indian democracy and development, and other subject also. So today we have with us, and we'll discussing about the civil society, the role of civil society in the social movement in the context of India, and we also discuss about other con. Okay. So Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra, over to you. Please deliver your lecture. Thank you.
So thank you very much, Antaryami.
Hello.
Today, I will. Can you hello. Hear me? Hello. Can you hear me?
Hello.
Yes.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Continue. Then it's okay. Let me start. So mic ko sabu.
Yes, sir. Continue.
Mic ko mute kar diya jao.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Today I'll be speaking on civil society and social movement, and before I start. Let us visit whatever I have said in two previous classes. In the first class, I talked about multiculturalism or multiculturalist. In the second class, I talked about identity politics, and I equated identity politics with social justice movement. And today, I will be talking about civil society and new social movement. All these concepts are quite interlinked, and the interlocker is that all are talking about about the marginalized section, how to protect them, and almost all these are talking about there are situations or possibilities where state can be consciously or unconsciously can be exploitative, and how to safeguard the freedom of minority or freedom of powerless people. So multiculturalism re bhi kahi chi, identity politics re bhi kali mu bahut katha kahi chi, last class, sorry, not Kali, last class. And today, I'll be speaking on civil society and social movement. I'll be speaking that why civil society is necessary today. And second, what is civil society? How civil society is connected with social movement? And what are the different kinds of social movement? And I'll be speaking on two kinds of social movement. The one is by the Gandhian passive resistance as a mode of social movement. And then Chantal Mouffe, his concept of radical democracy, his concept of social movement. So let me start with the past, that why civil society or we need civil society today, why civil society is necessary. To understand it, I think we need to understand the nature of our development strategy of India. After the independence or in the post-independent period, if you look at the development strategy of India, then you will find that the socio-economic problems, both urban and rural area, it is still persisting past. Second, then you will find that the tribe or hilly tribe, hilly tribal people, they are being neglected. Then the third, the failure to solve the problems of poverty, illiteracy, and insecurities. So all these, three negative things, you will find at the end if you analysis the development strategy of India. And what is wrong in this development strategy? And you, at the end, most of the analysis, I mean, bahut bada research hai kya upare, and most of the analysis, at the end, it blames the state. What is the problem with the state? Why they are blaming with the state? They found that it is because of the state-centric development approach. State-centric development approach, the real democratic participation of local community has been precluded. Has been precluded. I mean, jonta hoba kotha seita hei paruni. Everything is being decided from the top. Development activity kariba pai chahuchu sei jaga ta amaro local community ku belong karuchi ame tankori jaga ku kinuche au tankori jaga re hi ame deindustrialization we develop industrialization but then we are not taking them into account. Local communities are not being included, whose living space has been used as the site of developmental activity. Tamane jaha jaga ku nei ki ame koruche jaharo locality ku nei ki ame developmental strategy adopt koruche aur development aba bibhinna industrialization ku ame establish koruche ame sei man ku hi count karunu. Decisions are being taken from the top, or what we can call it state centric developmental approach. This is the main reason. Probably most of the analysis ei kothata ku hi they're coming to this conclusion. So such consequences has pushed democracy at the back foot. Ta mane democracy is all about thinking about that last individual. Democracy is all about thinking about powerless people. Democracy is all about local community. So jatebele development amar local community ko ta sahito nau nahi to setebele kon hochi na democracy tike back foot ko pale asuchi. Democracy has been pushed at the back foot, and when democracy is at is back footed, then new social or social movement emerges. Social movements have to start hue. Social movement ro main intention kon? Now, social movement ro main intention was to protect the democratic value, to protect democracy. That is only goal of social movement, or only aim. There may be several objectives. There is always a difference between the aim and objective. So the goal is to strengthen the democracy and to ensure democracy. That is the goal of social movement. And there is the resurgence of civil society. That means if there is civil society, then only social movement is possible. And when there is social movement, then civil society can be strengthened. So the relation between the social movement and the civil society, it is dialectical. Both need each other to grow. So an active civil society is the precondition of a true democracy. I mean, if you want to have a democracy or true democracy in true sense, then you have to, you know, create the civil society. You have to nurture the civil society. Civil society is there to guide the state in its proper direction. So an active civil society is always a precondition of true democracy. Now, what is that civil society? What is a civil society? To understand this question, what is a civil society, we need to understand what is not a civil society. That means certainly civil society is not the state. That means what doesn't come under state, then it comes under civil society. This is a very, you know, a very commonsensical understanding. So civil society means it embraces entire range of assumptions, values, institutions such as political, social, and civil rights. To David Held, it is made of area of social life such as domestic world, economic sphere, cultural activity, and political interaction. So all these constitute the civil society. But civil society certainly it doesn't have the power what state has. But civil society has its own power. Civil society is not state. The non-state is actually civil society. And in civil society, you may talk about, you know, political right. You may talk about social right. You may talk about civil right. So this is the civil society, and that is organized voluntarily outside the control of the state. That means if state is controlling, then it is not civil society. If it is not within the control of the state, then it is civil society. So to understand what is civil society and what is not civil society, then we need to understand whether state is linked. If state is linked, then it is not civil society. If state is not linked, linked means if it is state is not controlling, then it is civil society. If the state is controlling, then it is not civil society. So for Neera Chanduk or Habermas, this civil society is the public sphere. So it is public because it formulates it is formally accessible. It is formally accessible to all, and in principles, we are all allowed to entry into this sphere as the bearer of rights. So why civil society is all about the public sphere? Both Neera Chanduk and Habermas, these are the questions. Why it is a public sphere? Because we all can access to it. And in principle, we all are allowed to be part of that. Why we all are allowed to be part of that? What is that minimum qualification? That minimum qualification to be part of civil society is that you must be a bearer of rights. You know, we all are bearer of rights. Even the aliens, they are having civil rights. Even the alien means the person who is not a citizen. The person who is not having the political right. Even an alien, he is also the bearer of right, and he is also, even it is open for the alien also to be part of the civil society. Hence, both Neera Chanduk and Habermas, they are saying that civil society is all about the public sphere. But it is not within the control of the state. The state cannot, you know, make rules for its functioning, for its, structure. So liberals and Marxists views public sphere differently. That means if civil society is all about the public sphere, then does public sphere same thing for all? Certainly not. I mean, if you ask the nature of, or meaning, nature and scope of public sphere to liberals, they will give a different answer. And if you ask the same question to Marxist, and they will give a different answer to it. Hence, for liberals, civil society presupposes a democratic state which is characterized by four things. Liberals manku jetra ame pachari chhe ki a public sphere ta kon na semane kahuchanti a public sphere presupposes a democratic state, and which is characterized by four things. First, accountability of the state. Second, limited government. Third, responsiveness of spontaneous life. Responsiveness of spontaneous life. And the fourth, interaction of civil society. So what is accountability of the state? The state is legally responsible. Accountable means legal responsibility is accountable. That means you can sue the state, and the state can also sue you. You can go again, you can knock at the door of our court, or you can knock at the door of our court against the state, and the state can also knock at the door against you also. That is accountability of the state. Then limited government. Limited government means that maximum governance, minimum government. Then the responsiveness to the spontaneous life. What is responsiveness to the spontaneous life? That means in our day-to-day life, if we face any problem, that's a spontaneous life. If we face any problem, then the state will give its response to us, as if we will feel that the state is always with us. That is responsiveness to spontaneous life. Then the interaction of the civil society. That means there must be a civil society. If all these four characteristics are there with the democratic state, civil society is there, right? So all these features are reflected in Locke's second treatise of government, where the concept of civil society plays a central role. It represents people's departure from the state of nature to establish legitimate power, or to establish a civil government. Locke's conception makes a sense of contrast between civil society and uncivil society. So in the liberals, who talked civil society first? Now it is the John Locke. For John Locke, civil society is very key to his political philosophy. Why civil society is key to his political philosophy? Now it is the civil society that it is the civil society that marks a departure from the state of nature. In the state of nature, that civility was not there. That civility was not there in this state of nature. Certain problems are there in this state of nature. And in the civil society, then a departure from that leads to a civil government. So civil society is in between the state of nature on one hand and the civil government on the other. So for Marxist, civil society is an area of class conflict. Liberals ko pani civil society ro pani area. Marxist ko pani civil society ro mane kona? Na it is a area of class conflict. It is a area of selfish competition. It is a area of exploitation, where the state acts to protect the interest of owning class. For them, state is independent of society, and society provides the base on which stood the superstructure. Hence, society represents economy and superstructure represents this state. So Marxist mane kon kouchanti na civil society hochi gute kon civil society it is all about class conflict. What happens in a society? What happens in a feudal society? What happens in a slavery society? So civil society mane gute slave society. Civil society means a feudal society. There is have, there is have not. Jo society re tumhe paibo, there is class conflict. Jo society re paibo, individuals are competing with each other with their vested interest. Jo society re tumhe paibo, there are exploitation from have side towards have not. So the state, in the Marxist understanding of civil society, the state protect the interest of owning class. So what the civil society or what is happening in the civil society, the state legitimizes it, that what is happening, that is right, that is correct. So for them, for Marxist, state is independent of society. That means state does not depend upon the society. State is independent and society provides the base on which the state stood. Here society means what? Society means economy. Economy is the base. What is the superstructure? Superstructure is the political. Political means state. So here in a Marxian sense, civil society means it is the base. Again, it means it is economy. And what is this superstructure? Superstructure is political. And that political is state. So one may sense it from the Hegelian concept of civil society. So for Hegel, civil society is an expression for an individualist and atomist atmosphere of middle class commercial society, in which relationships are external, governed by the unseen hand of economic laws rather than by the self-conscious will. A self-conscious will of persons. So for Hegel, civil society means what? The civil society means it is a middle class commercial society. It is a middle class commercial society. And what is the nature of middle class? Now that the nature of middle class is that they are very self-centric, they are very competitive in nature, and they are all guided by the money, monetary consideration. For them, money is everything. Money can buy everything. They are just different to Michael Sandel and his book, What Money Cannot, individuals, they will, perhaps they will say you that money can buy everything. So for Hegel, civil society is the middle class commercial society where the relationships are not internal to itself. The relationships are always external. External means money guides the relationship. There is a monetary impact over the behavior of individuals. And it is governed by the unseen hand of economic laws rather than self-conscious will of the person. माने इंडिविजुअल एटा चिंता करनी कि मोर कोन करबा उचित हो आई शुड गो बियॉन्ड द इकोनॉमी एंड आई शुड थिंक व्हाट आई शुड डू एंड व्हाट आई शुड नॉट डू बट हीगल कोज इन द सिविल सोसाइटी रे सच काइंड ऑफ मोरालिटी यू विल नॉट फाउंड और यू विल नॉट फाइंड व्हाट यू विल फाइंड दैट एवरी इंडिविजुअल्स आर गाइडेड बाय द इकोनॉमी रिलेशनशिप पर्सनल रिलेशनशिप डज नॉट मैटर व्हाट मैटर्स वेदर यू आर हैविंग अर्निंग और नॉट. Your earning is a sense of power to you. And you don't understand the question of morality or ethics. Kubi kichhi matra re anubhav karuchu ki ajika samaj re bi jo mane middle class achanti taanko pai economy kete important jinish hoi jauchi. Amo bhitare kemiti competition ta bi chaluchi. आमे परस्पर को कम्पीट करबा पई चाहू छु आमे परस्पर को ओनो सरपास करबा पई चाहू छु আমি চাহুছু আমি এই কথা কৌছু আই নো হোয়াট আই এম ইউ ডোন্ট হ্যাভ এনি রাইট টু 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 ইউ নো ক্যারেক্টারাইজ মি দ্যাট কাইন্ড অফ ইউ নো ইন্ডিভিজুয়ালিস্ট অ্যাটিটিউড দ্যাট কাইন্ড অফ ইউ নো অটোমিস্টিক অ্যাটিটিউড ইন্ডিভিজুয়ালস আর হ্যাভিং অ্যান্ড উই অল আর বিং গাইডেড বাই সার্টেন এক্সটার্নাল ফোর্স অ্যান্ড দ্যাট এক্সটার্নাল ফোর্স ইজ নথিং বাট দি ইকোনমিক লজ রেদার দেন দি সেলফ কনসিয়াস will of the person jontaku mu kahuchi morality and ethics so from hegelian perspective civil society is a negative institution jodi ei sabu jinsa rahila then civil society cannot be positive civil society to marginalization ko strengthen kala se to marginalization ba oppression ko to defeat hi kala defeat man ta ko deal hi kala ni it legitimizes whatever happens within the society the state legitimizes whatever happens within the society so from hegelian perspective civil society is a negative institution which belong to the realm of mechanical necessity a resultant of irrational forces of individual desire that means jetebale civil society re ethics or morality rahuni tabe civil society gote gote mechanical type ram ko laguchi ଯେମିତି ଲାଗୁଛି ସ୍ୱାମୀ ସ୍ତ୍ରୀ ଭିତରେ ସମ୍ପର୍କଟା ମେକାନିକାଲ ହେଇଗଲାଣି ପିଲାମାନଙ୍କର ବାପା ମାଆଙ୍କ ସହିତ ସମ୍ପର୍କଟା ମେକାନିକାଲ ହେଇଗଲାଣି ସୋସାଇଟିର ମାନେ ସୋସାଇଟି ଆଉ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଭିତରେ ସମ୍ପର୍କଟା ବି ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ମେକାନିକାଲ ହେଇଗଲାଣି ଯେମିତିକି ଲାଗୁଛି ଆମର ଗୋଟେ ଭେଷ୍ଟେଡ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟ ଅଛି ସେଥିପାଇଁ ଆମେ ୱି ଆର୍ ରିଲେଟେଡ୍ ଦ ହଜବେଣ୍ଡ ଇଜ୍ ହାଭିଂ ଭେଷ୍ଟେଡ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟ ଦ ୱାଇଫ୍ ଇଜ୍ ହାଭିଂ ଭେଷ୍ଟେଡ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ସ ୱାଇ ସେମାନେ ପାଖାପାଖି ଆସିକି ରହୁଛନ୍ତି ଭେଷ୍ଟେଡ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟ ସରିଗଲା ତ ସେମାନେ ପରସ୍ପର ଠାରୁ ଦୂରେଇକି ପଳେଇଗଲେ ଟିଚର ଆଉ ଷ୍ଟୁଡେଣ୍ଟ ଭିତରେ ବି ଆମେ ସେଇ ପ୍ରକାରର ଜିନିଷ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ଯେଉଁଟା ଆଗରୁ ଏଇସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ନଥିଲା ଟିଚର ଷ୍ଟୁଡେଣ୍ଟ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ଭେରି ୟୁ ନୋ ଭେରି ସଲିଡ୍ ରିଲେସନ୍ସିପ୍ ଥିଲା ଯେଉଁଟାକି ଆମେ ଦେଖିପାରିବା ବିଭିନ୍ନ ଆମର ପ୍ଲାଟୋ ଆଉ ଆରିଷ୍ଟଟଲଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଆମେ ସେ ସମ୍ପର୍କ ଦେଖିପାରିବା ଆମେ ପ୍ଲାଟୋ ସକ୍ରେଟିସ୍ ଭିତରେ ସେ ସମ୍ପର୍କ ଦେଖିପାରିବା ସେଇ ସମ୍ପର୍କଟା ଆଜି ଆମକୁ ଦେଖାଯାଉ ନାହିଁ କେଉଁଠି ନା କେଉଁଠି ଏଭ୍ରିଥିଂ ଇଜ୍ ବିକମିଂ ମେକାନିକାଲ everything is becoming you know becoming irrational kind of thing so what is mechanical that is actually irrational I always say too much rationality is actually irrationality too much you think about 2 plus 2 is equal to 4 then in reality you may not find it in reality you know truth always lies in the gray area not in black and white so for Hegel the civil society is negative the civil society is mechanical the civil society is irrational because these are all guided by the external factor that is economy not the internal factor like ethics and morality however for Gramsci is another Marxist thinker for Gramsci civil society it is not a negative institution and without understanding the civil society the state cannot be understood so Gramsci brought that ethics or moral or ethical or moral part moral aspect to and attached it to civil society and Gramsci linked the state with the civil society so let us understand what is Gramsci understanding of civil society so for Gramsci civil society is the result of a complex network of social practices fundamental classes that is capital and labor so for Gramsci is always above the binary Gramsci always thinks in terms of dialectics for Gramsci the capital and labor and the relation between the capital and labor are not mutually exclusive to each other rather than they are mutually inclusive how it is inclusive that without labor the capital is of no use and without capital you cannot capitalize the labor to capitalize the labor you need capital and to you know strengthen the capital or to develop more and more capital you need the labor so rich needs poor and poor needs the rich so for Gramsci in civil society you may find that there are two fundamental classes. That fundamental classes is the haves and have not, bourgeois and proletarian, and there is a continuous struggle between these two classes, and that struggle is all about, we are different, but at the same time we need each other. We are different, but at the same time we need each other. So it is a sphere where the capitalist workers engages in political and ideological struggle. So there is ideological struggle between the capitalism or between the bourgeois and proletariat, but at the same time there are also the dependency, there are also dialogue between these haves and have not, there are also various kinds of struggle within the civil society. So it is not only a class struggle. Civil society does not represent not only the class struggle, but also a sphere of all popular democratic struggles which arise out of different ways in which people are grouped together by race, by sex, by caste, by region, by age, etc. तमाने सिविल सोसाइटी रे केवल माने क्लास को नै कि गोटे प्रकार रो स्ट्रगल होउनी हैव्स आउ हैव नॉट भितरे सिविल सोसाइटी रे एनवायरनमेंट को नै कि भी एजिटेशन होउची सिविल सोसाइटी रे जेंडर को नै कि भी एजिटेशन होउची जोंडा फेमिनिज्म आमे कथा कहउचे फेमिनिज्म कथा कहउचे सिविल सोसाइटी रे आमे कास्ट एक्सप्लोइटेशन ताको भी आमे रेज करूचे सिविल सोसाइटी रे आमे रीजनल डिस्क्रिमिनेशन बा रीजनल इंबैलेंसेस ताकु भी आमे डिस्क्राइब करूचे बा डिस्कशन करूचे आउ सिविल सोसाइटी रे अमर जो ओल्ड एज को प्रति जो गोटे प्रकार डिस्क्रिमिनेशन होची एज डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एज एज रे बुढ़ा लोक माने भी आसीबे एज रे छोटो छोटो पिला माने भी आसीबे से कथा भी आमे सिविल सोसाइटी रे रेज करी परिबा कैना सिविल सोसाइटी केवल क्लास स्ट्रगल को रिप्रेजेंट करूनी सिविल सोसाइटी पॉपुलर डेमोक्रेटिक स्ट्रगल को रिप्रेजेंट करुछि एनवायरमेंट जो एनवायरमेंटलिस्ट अछंती जो माने फेमिनिस्ट अछंती जो माने दोज हु आर फाइटिंग अगेंस्ट द कास्ट राइट जोंटा तुम्हें कहि परियो बापसा कहि परियो बा अंबेडकर स्टूडेंट एसोसिएशन दे आर फाइटिंग फॉर डेमोक्रेटिक वैल्यू ऑन द इन कनेक्शन टू द कास्ट राइट So these struggles these are part of the civil society. Jonta eighty actually Gramsci left taru tikke duro ko asile. Gramsci kon kale na left ko gote new left aduko nei gale. Jo new left ta it goes beyond the essential character of Marxism and it tries to include all forms of struggle that intends to protect democracy. Hence, civil society for Gramsci is an ethical moral society. Civil society for Gramsci is an ethical and moral society because it is based on consent building, not on coercion. Eta hochi important jinsa Gramsci kar jo civil society understanding achi that civil society always try to build the consensus. Civil society does not apply any kind of power, psychological power, political power, economic power. Civil society does not use that. Civil society is basically the character of civil society for Gramsci. It is all about ethical and moral. That money, jota Hegel ko chandi ki money guide koru thala, but Gramsci ko civil society re money guide kori bani. Guide kya kori bo? Na ethical or moral. Ethics of morality that will guide the civil society, not the economy. So to Gramsci, civil society is different from political society, and political society is different from the state. Civil society is different from political society, and political society is different from the state. How to understand? So for him, political society is based on coercion. तेणु आम सिविल सोसाइटी देखिलु सिविल सोसाइटी इज बेस्ड ऑन एथिक्स एंड मोरालिटी एंड एथिक्स एंड मोरालिटी लीड्स टू कंसेंसस तेणु सिविल सोसाइटी ट्राइज टू बिल्ड अप दैट कंसेंसस एंड सिविल सोसाइटी डज नॉट बिलीव इन कोर्जन एंड डज नॉट अप्लाई द कोर्जन दिस इज सिविल सोसाइटी But the opposite is the political society. Political society, kaana? Now, political society is based on coercion. For him, political society is based on coercion, which are materialized in various institutions of the state. Kaana? Now, such as armed forces, then police, then law, legal system, courts, then prisons. These are jodi ame gote sense re kahiba, these are the administrative department of the government. These are the administrative department of the government. And there are also taxation, finance, trade, industry, that is the economic department of the government. तेणु आम जो पॉलिटिकल इंस्टीट्यूशन कथा कहचे से बेसिकली यही एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव डिपार्टमेंट आउ इकोनॉमिक डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ़ दि गवर्नमेंट को ही बुझुचे मैंने व्हाट आर दि व्हाट इज दैट पॉलिटिकल सोसाइटी फॉर ग्राम्सी फॉर पॉलिटिकल द पॉलिटिकल सोसाइटी ऑफ ग्राम्सी इज टू थिंग्स वन इज एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव डिपार्टमेंट द अदर इज द इकोनॉमिक डिपार्टमेंट एंड इन बोथ द डिपार्टमेंट यू मे फाइंड कोर्जन इज पार्ट. Coercion is the last resort. They can apply coercion against you. If you don't follow the rules and regulation, then the state or the government, I'm not talking about state. There is a difference between the political society and state. Here, political society means a society that believes in the coercion. And what is, what believes in the, or what are those institutions? Now, those institutions are the institution of administrative department and institutions of economic department. These duita ko chadi de salla pore, how government ra konosi institution nahi jounti they can apply the coercion. So both administrative and economic department depend in its last resort for their effectiveness. And what is the last resort? The last resort is applying coercion for maintaining law and order. So political society means a society which believes and apply the coercion at the last resort. And what is the example of political society for Gramsci? The example of political society for Gramsci is institutions of administrative departments and institutions of economic department. What are the institutions of administrative department? Jonta Mukahili, armed force, police, law, courts, prisons. What are the institutions of economic department? Then I told you it is finance, trade, industry, taxation. These are the institutions of economic department. And both these department, they believe in coercion. Hence, both these department belongs to political society. However, for Gramsci, activities of state is far more than coercion. Tamane, state is not government. State is government plus. State means state is government plus. स्टेट रो काम नुह केवल यू नो लोक कोर्जन एप्लाय करिबा स्टेट रो काम होची कोर्जन छड़ा आउ किछि भी जिनस को यू नो इम्पोर्टेंस दबा ना द स्टेट अपरेटस मस्ट प्ले ए वाइटल रोल इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ कंसेंट एटी आसला द कनेक्शन बिटवीन द सिविल सोसाइटी एंड द स्टेट तनो स्टेट रो काम कोन जेमती सिविल सोसाइटी रो काम कंसेंट बिल्डिंग करिवो कंसेंसस बिल्डिंग करिवो समिति स्टेट रो भी काम होती कौन ना स्टेट मस्ट नर्चर और स्टेट मस्ट प्ले ए वाइटल रोल इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ द कंसेंट ता माने जोंटा सिविल सोसाइटी करूची सेटा स्टेट मध्य करिवो इफ स्टेट डज सो देन इट इज नोन एज एजुकेटिव एंड फॉर्मेटिव रोल ऑफ द स्टेट तेणु स्टेट रो दीटा जिनस अछि स्टेट रो दी प्रकार रोल अछि गोटे प्रकार रोल कौन ना इट इज एजुकेटिव एंड फॉर्मेटिव रोल एटा स्टेट रो गोटे प्रकार रोल आउ गोटे प्रकार रोल कौन अच्छे कौन ना एप्लाइंग दि कोर्जन जो फास्ट रोल ले द स्टेट मोस्टली डज दि वर्क ऑफ सिविल सोसाइटी जहा करूची एटी स्टेट भी सेया करूची स्टेट रो आउ गोटे एस्पेक्ट रोचे जोंटा गवर्नमेंट जोटे मुझे एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव और इकोनॉमिक डिपार्टमेंट से स्टेट कोर्स अप्लाई करती तेणु आम जब मैथमेटिकली देखा स्टेट मीन्स स्टेट इज और स्टेट इज इक्वल टू पॉलिटिकल सोसाइटी प्लस सिविल सोसाइटी स्टेट इज इक्वल टू पॉलिटिकल सोसाइटी प्लस सिविल सोसाइटी सो स्टेट रिप्रेजेंट्स बोथ सिविल सोसाइटी एंड पॉलिटिकल सोसाइटी Now, if you see the Locke's political philosophy and Gramscian political philosophy, then you will find there are certain commonalities. What is that commonalities? Now, civil society is not a uncivil society. Rather than, civil society is a moral and ethical society. Jota Locke context re kon thila na state of nature ta gude uncivil society thila. ସେମାନେ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ନେଚରକୁ ଛାଡ଼ିକି ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟିରେ ଜଏନ୍ କଲେ ତେଣୁ ଲ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଡିପାର୍ଚର୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଅନ୍ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ଟୁ ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ଗ୍ରାମ୍ସି ବି ସେଇ କଥା କହୁଛନ୍ତି ମାନେ ଗ୍ରାମ୍ସି ଇଜ୍ ନେଗେଟିଙ୍ଗ ହିଗେଲ୍ ଗ୍ରାମ୍ସି କହୁଛନ୍ତି ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ନେଗେଟିଭ୍ ରଦର୍ ଦେନ୍ ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ଇଜ୍ ପଜିଟିଭ୍ ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ଡଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ବିଲିଭ୍ ଇନ୍ କୋର୍ଜନ୍ ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ହେଜ୍ ଏ ୟୁ ନୋ ମୋରାଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏଥିକାଲ୍ ଏସ୍ପେକ୍ଟ ଟୁ ଆଟାଚ୍ ଟୁ ଇଟ୍ ଅନ୍ ହୁଇଜ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ And both of them kouchanti kana now once the civil society strong hela tebe jai ki state ta asi paribo ba state ta strong hei paribo taku agute mane in other words samta kon kahi pariba na if the state wants itself to be deeply rooted or if the state wants to be strong then it has to create the civil society it has to nurture the civil society it is in fact the civil society which strengthen the state so for both Locke and Gramsci without civil society state cannot be imagined one important lesson that Gramsci tells us that civil society is not anti state eita gute 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 prakar ra ajika tume jodi atmosphere ku ame jodi dekhibo ame ei jinsa ta ku paibo that if you are not anti state then you are not part of the civil society I'm repeating if you are not anti state then you are not part of the civil society people will think that you are the agent of the state if you are speaking something for the state then there is a there is a blame that you are the agent of the state and you cannot be the part of the civil society kahi na kahile bhi it is very much psychological everything is psychological right बट ग्रामसी कहते जरूरी नुह सिविल सोसाइटी इज ऑलवेज एंटी स्टेट यू नो सिविल सोसाइटी कैन बी ऑल्सो प्रो स्टेट राइट सो सिविल सोसाइटी इज नॉट एंटी स्टेट एज लॉन्ग एज स्टेट इज नॉट एंटी सिविल सोसाइटी ने इफ द स्टेट प्रोटेक्ट सिविल सोसाइटी स्टेट नर्चर सिविल सोसाइटी देन सिविल सोसाइटी विल आल्सो स्ट्रेंथन द स्टेट बट जदि स्टेट सिविल सोसाइटी को एंटी करिवो इफ द स्टेट यू नो डिसमिस सिविल सोसाइटी इफ द स्टेट ट्राइज टू डिसमेंटल सिविल सोसाइटी देन द सिविल सोसाइटी आल्सो बिकम्स एंटी स्टेट ग्रामसी एई कथा भी कहउछन्ती कि सिविल सोसाइटी कैन बी प्रो स्टेट सिविल सोसाइटी कैन बी एंटी स्टेट प्रो स्टेट केते बेले हबो ना जते बेले स्टेट प्रॉपर्ली बिहेव टू द सिविल सोसाइटी इफ द स्टेट बिहेव इम्प्रॉपर्ली देन द सिविल सोसाइटी विल बी एंटी स्टेट एंड इफ स्टेट इज अगेंस्ट सिविल सोसाइटी एंड एंजॉयज द फ्रूट ऑफ पैसिव रिवोल्यूशन देन सिविल सोसाइटी कैन और सिविल सोसाइटी कैन फॉलो द active revolution ba jonta gramsci kouchanti anti passive revolution ba jonta gandhi kouchanti passive resistance eti tike confusion au tike clear kariba eti na au thare mu repeat karuchi if the state is against civil society and enjoys the fruit of passive revolution eita ku bujhibar ach then what is passive revolution why am I saying that when the state is against civil society and enjoys passive revolution jatal se state mane mu satale kouchi elite man ko katha kouchi jo mane head of the state mu both regime katha kouchi mu fascism katha kouchi mu communism katha bhi kouchi na jete bele state you know सिविल सोसाइटी रो एगेंस्ट रे छिड़ा हबो और पैसिव रिवॉल्यूशन लो जहाँ किसी फ्रूट्स अच्छी जदि से निजे सेटा को एंजॉय करिवो देन द सिविल सोसाइटी फॉलो द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ एक्टिव रिवॉल्यूशन ताको ग्रामसी आउ गोटे वार्ड भी कहते दैट इज एंटी पैसिव रिवॉल्यूशन गांधी ताको कहते पैसिव रेजिस्टेंस तो आपको टिके बुझिबार अछि व्हाट इज पैसिव रिवॉल्यूशन व्हाट इज द फ्रूट्स ऑफ पैसिव रिवॉल्यूशन हाउ एलिट्स आर एंजॉइंग द फ्रूट्स ऑफ पैसिव रिवॉल्यूशन बट दे आर नॉट you know properly behaving towards civil society. They are not giving due consideration to the civil society, and hence they are anti civil society. Kon se passive revolution ta kon ame seti 2 3 minute ke biteiba to know the passive revolution. So what is that passive revolution? Now passive revolution, it is the transformation of political and institutional structure without a strong social process. So what is a passive revolution? Now passive revolution, it is a process of modernization, and in this process of modernization, it is presided by the established elite who used revolutionary changes to maintain their supremacy and consolidate the extent of order. This supremacy rested upon a narrow consensual foundation. Yet because of popular leaders were assimilated into the system, and because the masses themselves did not possess the cultural sophistication to fit their grievances into anything resembling a coherent framework, social discontent while prevalent lacked any direction whatsoever. Thus, in a negative sense, people were subjected to intellectual and moral hegemony of ruling group. But it was an exceedingly weak hegemony, marked by low level of integration. Tale passive revolution ta ko tike ame bujhiba that amaro fascist government chali asila, amaro communist government chali asila. जेतेबेले फासिस्ट गवर्नमेंट आसला कम्युनिस्ट गवर्नमेंट आसला गोटे पटे हिटलर छिड़ा हेले गोटे पटे स्टालिन छिड़ा हो गले नाउ ये हिटलर और लिन भितर डिफरेंस कौन देर इज नो मच डिफरेंस जने एक्सट्रीम राइट जने एक्सट्रीम लेफ्ट तांक भितर सिमिलारिटी अछि से सिमिलारिटीटा कौन ना बोथ आर दि फॉलोअर ऑफ पैसिव रिवॉल्यूशन ए बोथ कौन करिसेंती ना दे आर ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग आफ्टर एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ द स्टेट यू नो नाजी नाजी स्टेट आसीगला एपटे कम्युनिस्ट स्टेट आसीगला आसी सारा पर एमाने लीडर हो गले एमाने लीडर हो सारा पर एमाने कौन कले ना दे ट्राई टू ब्रिंग सर्टेन ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन कौन ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ना पॉलिटिकल और इंस्टीट्यूशनल स्ट्रक्चर रे किसी ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन आने चाहिए कि ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन गोटे स्ट्रॉन्ग सोशल बेस नाला मानते जोटा को आम कहे गोटे वीक हेजिमनी थी सेठे गोटे लो लेवल ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन थिला ता माने जोंटा कि समान कहुतले जोंटा आमे कहि परबा द वैनगार्ड पार्टी द यू नो द वर्कर्स और द प्रोलेटेरिएट दे डू नॉट नो व्हाट इज देयर इंटरेस्ट सो इट इज द वैनगार्ड पार्टी दैट विल टेल देम दैट व्हाट इज योर इंटरेस्ट व्हाट इज योर कॉन्शियसनेस दैट ग्राम्सी अंडरस्टैंड सेठी ग्राम्सी कहउचंदि कोन इफ यू स्पीक सो देन यू आर नो डिफरेंट फ्रॉम हिटलर If Stalin, if you are using so, then you are no different from Hitler, because both of the political regime, you can find that there is a low level of integration, and people are subjected to intellectual and moral hegemony of the ruling class. And lokomane au kichi conscious chinta kaleni. Se sabu mane lokomane badhi hoi gale tankaro Hitler upare depend kariya pai. लोक मैंने बाधे गले स्टालिन उपरे डिपेंड करने एलिट मैंने कौन कले ना एलिट मैंने गोटे रिवोल्यूशनरी मेथड को व्यवहार कले सुप्रीमासी को से मेंटेन कले गोटे सुप्रीमासी को मेंटेन कले गोटे ऑर्डर को से माने एस्टैब्लिश कले एंड दिस सुप्रीमासी इट डजंट हैव ए कंसेंसुअल फाउंडेशन एटा गोटे रिवोल्यूशनरी गोटे गोटे इट्स फाउंडेशन इज रिवोल्यूशन its foundation is not evolution revolution evolution bhitare gote parthakya ach evolutionary process re कौन हुए ना टीके समय लगे पीपुल थिंक देन पीपुल गिव देयर कंसेंट आउ सेटा टीके इवोल्यूशनरी प्रोसेस रे गुटे कंसेंसुअल फाउंडेशन टीके स्ट्रांग थाय बट रिवोल्यूशनरी प्रोसेस रे यू नो पीपुल आर गाइडेड बाय देयर सेंटीमेंट नॉट बाय देयर रेशनालिटी सेठी तुम देख कंसेंसुअल फाउंडेशन रिवोल्यूशनरी अप्रोच रे टीके वीक थाय राइट सो दिस इज द पैसिव रिवोल्यूशन तेणु पैसिव रिवोल्यूशन कौन कला ना आकु आई मीन हिटलर बा मुसोलिनी आउ एपटे स्टालिनी स्टालिन एमान को एप्रोप्रिएट करेला आउ एमान कर पोजिशन को स्ट्रेंथन करेला लोक माने एमान को डरिबा आरंभ कले जिमती लास्ट क्लास रे मु आई वाज सेइंग दैट इफ कम्युनिज्म इज ऑल अबाउट पीपल देन व्हाई कम्युनिस्ट गवर्नमेंट किल्स इट्स ओन पीपल So you need to think about, I mean, eta ko bahut loko bartan, you know, eta ko samna ko anileni, it is not a new thing, ame samaste seita ko janichu. Now this is passive revolution. Seithi pai, ame tike come back kariba, na jatabale state, passive revolution, state mane the elites. जितेबले एलिट्स मैंने passive revolution को तार fruits को enjoy करुछंती, जितेबले state doesn't have or doesn't work towards a broader base state is happy with the narrow integration but weak integration then the state is against the civil society sadavale foundation ko strong karai thai now jebe state you know follows the passive revolution and weaken the civil society then the civil society follows active revolution ba gramsci ta ko kahuchanti kana na गांधी ताको कहते पैसिव रेजिस्टेंस सो व्हेदर इट इज यू नो एक्टिव रिवॉल्यूशन व्हेदर इज इट इज एंटी पैसिव रिवॉल्यूशन और व्हेदर इट इज पैसिव रेजिस्टेंस ऑल दीज आर कॉल्ड सोशल मूवमेंट्स दे आर डूइंग ए मूवमेंट्स एंड व्हाट इज द गोल ऑफ सोशल मूवमेंट द गोल ऑफ सोशल मूवमेंट इज टू मेक द बेस ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी वेरी स्ट्रांग very deeply rooted whenever there are certain undemocratic things happens then the social movements play a very greater role ame kahi pariba jemti they are the vanguard of democracy I mean they guard the democracy they are the guarding tumi check koruchanti social movements always you know check whether democracy the principles of democracy is getting violated or not sada bale seita ku se check karuchi now all these are called the social movement which is not possible without civil society mane jodi civil society nahi tebe social movements kari hobani aa jodi social movements hei paruchi then civil society is also strengthening civil society स्ट्रंग हूँ तेणु स्टेट राम हो सिविल सोसाइटी को यू नो स्पेस दब सिविल सोसाइटी को स्ट्रेंथन कर इफ स्टेट डज सो देन स्टेट इज फॉर सिविल सोसाइटी जदि स्टेट इज नेगेटिंग यू नो सोशल मूवमेंट्स इफ द स्टेट इज नेगेटिंग सोशल मूवमेंट्स देन द स्टेट इज नॉट फॉर सिविल सोसाइटी द स्टेट इज एंटी सिविल सोसाइटी सो देर आर मेनी काइंड्स ऑफ सोशल मूवमेंट्स So I will, you know, describe two kinds of social movements: that Gandhian passive resistance and the Chanthalmophi radical democracy. So these two kinds of social movement, I will talk about what is the nature of the Gandhian passive resistance. What is the nature of this Gandhi's own theory of social, you know, movement? Jonta ko Gandhi ko chanti passive resistance. Now for Gandhi so passive resistance for Gandhi means what na Gandhi ka context kon thila na on one hand state is there the Britishers are there they are the oppressor and who are the oppressed The freedom fighters are the oppressed. तनु आमे ताको गोटे सेंस रे धरी परिवा जदी यूरोपियन प्रोस्पेक्टिव रे जदी आमे देखिवा जदी स्टेट टा हैव हैला तबे फ्रीडम फाइटर्स होचंदी हैव नॉट हम एकोटे एनालॉजी को आमे आनुछ एंड वी आर ट्राइंग कारण पैसिव resistance, anti-passive revolution. Anti-passive revolution is a European concept. Passive resistance is an Indian concept. But there is a resemblance. तेणु आमको यू नो गोटे एनालोजी आणवाई पड़ो तेणु आम देखुचे ब्रिटिशर ऑपरेसिंग स्टेट पावर तेरे अच्छी आखिर फ्रीडम फाइटर्स दे आर दि ऑप्रेस्ड दे आर दि हेल्पलेस इंडिविजुअल एंड दे डोंट हैव देयर ओन फ्रीडम इन सो सिचुएशन गांधी एडप्टेड दि पैसिव रेजिस्टेंस गांधी पैसिव रेजिस्टेंस रे पांचटा प्रिंसिपल थिला पांचटा प्रिंसिपल कौन ना प्रथम हूँ ट्रुथ द्वितीय प्रिंसिपल हूँ नॉन वायलेंस तृतीय प्रिंसिपल हूँ सत्याग्रह चतुर्थ प्रिंसिपल हूँ नॉन कोऑपरेशन एंड पंचम प्रिंसिपल्स हूँ गुड एंड एंड गुड मीन्स सो व्हाट इज ट्रुथ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द पैसिव रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ गांधी और द नेचर ऑफ पैसिव रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द गांधी और व्हाट आर द स्ट्रैटेजी ऑफ पैसिव रेजिस्टेंस First is truth. Truth means what? When I'm saying morally non-corrupt, there is a difference between legal non-corrupt and moral non-corrupt. Legal non-corrupt means that you are not lying legally. Legally, you are saying the right thing, but morally, it is wrong. Legally, you are saying right thing, but morally, it is wrong. Example, mind ko asuni. But if you think you can also get the example gandhi kouchanti legal correctness is not truth moral correctness is the truth there is always a difference between the legal and the moral so if you are morally non corrupt then even when you are failing even at the time of failure that you will not leave the truth सत्य सहित तुम रही मोर क्षति होगा सत्य को छाड़देवी आज मु लीगली गोटे एडवांटेज पाइबी से मु मोरालिटी को देखी आई विल स्पीक अस्वस्थमा हत नरभा कुंजर अस्वस्थमा हत नरभा कुंजर इट मे बी लीगली राइट बट इट इज मोराली रंग इट इज हाफ ट्रुथ एंड हाफ ट्रुथ मीन्स हाफ फॉल्स ट्रुथ इज ऑलवेज 100% Truth cannot be 50% or 99%. So Gandhiji was thinking that that if you are the seeker of truth or you are on the path of truth, then even at the time of failure, you will not leave the truth. And why truth is very essential for Gandhi? Now, for Gandhi, truth is having the higher utility. A truthful person cannot harm his or her opponents. जे सत कौच से केवे कहारी एनिमी हो पारन बट इट इज अनफर्चुनेट टुडे आज आम जो कौन सत कथ कौ देन वी बिकम एनिमी एटा आम मैंने भी रियलाइज करुचु से गोटे कनसेप्ट आसीगला दैट पॉलिटिकल करेक्टनेस दैट मीन्स यू हैव टू बी पॉलिटिकली करेक्ट वी डोंट वांट यू टू बी करेक्ट बट पॉलिटिकली करेक्ट ए ट्रुथफुल पर्सन कैन नॉट हार हिज और हार ओपोनेंट्स बट He will make them friends. If there is no truth, then there is no friendship. Lying cannot be the base of any relationship. Lying cannot be the base of friendship. A society based on truth can be an ideal society. No truth, no ideal society. Jonta Ambedkar kor gote tanka autobiography achi. वेटिंग फॉर ए विसा से गोटे बढ़िया कथा कही नो पियन नो वाटर तो सही सेन्स रे मुझे कह ची नो ट्रुथ नो आइडियल सोसाइटी दैट इज द रिलेवेंस ऑफ ट्रुथ एंड व्हाई यू विल फॉलो द ट्रुथ बिकॉज ट्रुथ हैज द पावर ट्रुथ गिव्स यू द मोरल करेज ट्रुथ गिव्स यू द मोरल करेज टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिशर The British are not the follower of truth. If they are the follower of truth, they would have left India. Since they are not follower of truth, they are follower of power and wealth. So to defeat the power and wealth, then you should have the truth. ଦାଟ ଇଜ ଦି ଟିକେ ବୁଝିବା ପାଇଁ ଟିକେ ଚେଷ୍ଟା କର। ଜଣଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ପାୱାର ଅଛି, ଜଣଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ଟଙ୍କା ପଇସା ଅଛି, ତୁମେ ତା ସହିତ ଫାଇଟ୍ କରିବ, କେମିତି ଫାଇଟ୍ କରିବ? ତମ ପାଖରେ ତ ପାୱାର ନାହିଁ, ତମ ପାଖରେ ତ ଟଙ୍କା ବି ନାହିଁ। ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଜଷ୍ଟ ଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ୱିଥ୍ ଦି ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ୱାନ୍ ଡେ ଦ ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଡିଫିଟ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମନି, ଦ ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଡିଫିଟ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ପାୱାର। ଦେନ୍ ଦି ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ନନ୍ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସ। ସୋ ଗାନ୍ଧି ୱାଜ୍ ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଦି ପ୍ରପାଗେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସ ଇନ୍ ୱାନ୍ସ ଥଟ୍, ୱାର୍ଡ୍ସ, ଆକ୍ସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡିଡ୍। ୱାଇ ନନ୍ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସ? କାରଣ ବ୍ରିଟିଶର ମାନେ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସ ୟୁଜ୍ କରୁଛନ୍ତି। ଆମେ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସ ଦ୍ୱାରା ତ ବ୍ରିଟିଶରକୁ ହରାଇ ପାରିବୁନୁ। ଆମ ପାଖରେ ଆର୍ମସ୍ ନାହିଁ, ଏମୁନିସନ୍, ଏସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଗୁଡ଼ା କିଛି ନାହିଁ। ତେଣୁ ଆମେ କ'ଣ କରିବୁ ନା, ୱିଲ୍ ଆଡପ୍ଟ ଦି ନନ୍ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସ। ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏ ପର୍ସନ୍ ହୁ ବିଲିଭ୍ ଇନ୍ ନନ୍ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସ ୱିଲ୍ ଟ୍ରାଏ ଟୁ ଚେଞ୍ଜ ଦି ହାର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଅଦର୍ସ ବାଏ ବିୟରିଂ ଦି ସଫରିଂ ଫର୍ ହିମସେଲ୍ଫ। ଗାନ୍ଧୀ ବହୁତ ପିଓର୍ କରିଥିଲେ, ମାନେ ଅମରଣ ଅନଶନ ଯେଉଁ ଗ୍ରହଣ କରିଥିଲେ, କାହିଁକି ସେ ନିଜ ଆଡ଼କୁ କଷ୍ଟଟା ନେଇଥିଲେ? କାହିଁକି ନା ନିଜ ଆଡ଼କୁ କଷ୍ଟ ନେଲେ ଜଣଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ହୃଦୟ ପରିବର୍ତ୍ତନ ହବ, ଆଉ ଯେଉଁ ପରିବର୍ତ୍ତନଟା ହୃଦୟ ପରିବର୍ତ୍ତନରୁ ହିଁ ଆସିଥାଏ ସେଇ ପରିବର୍ତ୍ତନଟା ଟିକେ ଷ୍ଟେବୁଲ ହେଇଥାଏ। ଅଦରୱାଇଜ୍ ଯଦି ହୃଦୟରୁ ପରିବର୍ତ୍ତନ ନ ଆସିଛି, ତେବେ ସେ ପରିବର୍ତ୍ତନଟା ଦ ଚେଞ୍ଜ ବିକମ୍ସ ସୁପରଫିସିଆଲ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ ସଲ୍ୟୁସନ୍ ବିକମ୍ସ ସୁପରଫିସିଆଲ। ଦେନ୍ ଦି ସତ୍ୟାଗ୍ରହ। ସତ୍ୟାଗ୍ରହ ମିନ୍ସ ୱାଟ୍ ନା, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ହୋଲ୍ଡିଂ ଦି ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍, ହୋଲ୍ଡିଂ ଦି ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭିଣ୍ଡିକେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍। ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଭିଣ୍ଡିକେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍, ନଟ୍ ବାଏ ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟିଂ ଅଫ୍ ସଫରିଂ ଅନ୍ ଦି ଅପୋନେଣ୍ଟ, ବଟ୍ ଅନ୍ ୱାନ୍ ସେଲ୍ଫ। ଯେଉଁଟା ନନ୍ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସରେ ଯେଉଁଟା ମୁଁ କହିଲି, ନନ୍ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସ, ସତ୍ୟାଗ୍ରହ, ନନ୍ କୋପରେସନ୍, ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ରାଇଟ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ରାଇଟ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଅଲ୍ ଆର୍ ଇଣ୍ଟରକନେକ୍ଟେଡ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ଇଚ୍ ଅଦର୍। ସୋ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ନୋ ମଚ୍ ଡିଫରେନ୍ସ ବିଟୱିନ୍ ଦି ୟୁ ନୋ ନନ୍ ଭାୟୋଲେନ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ସତ୍ୟାଗ୍ରହ, ବଟ୍ ହିଅର୍ ସତ୍ୟାଗ୍ରହ ମିନ୍ସ ସତ୍ ଯୁକ୍ତ ଆଗ୍ରହ। ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ହୋଲ୍ଡ ଦି ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଟ୍ରୁଥ୍ ମଷ୍ଟ ବି ଫ୍ରମ୍ ୟୋର୍ ହାର୍ଟ। ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ଯେଉଁଟାକୁ ଗାନ୍ଧୀ କହୁଛନ୍ତି, ସତ୍ୟାଗ୍ରହ ମଷ୍ଟ ବି ବେସ୍ଡ ଅନ୍ ସୋଲ୍ ଫୋର୍ସ, ନଟ୍ ଫିଜିକାଲ୍ ଫୋର୍ସ। ତେଣୁ ଅପୋନେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ମାନଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ରହିଛି ଫିଜିକାଲ୍ ଫୋର୍ସ, ତୁମ ପାଖରେ ରହିଛି ସୋଲ୍ ଫୋର୍ସ। ତୁମେ ମୋତେ ଯେତେ ବାଡ଼େଇବ ମୁଁ ତୁମକୁ ବାଡ଼େଇବିନି, ମୁଁ ସେତେ ମାଡ଼ ଖାଇବି। ତୁମେ ବାଡ଼େଇ ବାଡ଼େଇ ଠକିଯିବ, ମୁଁ ମାଡ଼ ଖାଇ ଖାଇ ଠକିବିନି। ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ସ ଦି ସୋଲ୍ ଫୋର୍ସ। ଇଭିନ୍ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ହିଟ୍ ଅନ୍ ଆୱାର୍ ବଡି, ଆୱାର୍ ବଡି ୱିଲ୍ ନଟ୍ ବି ଏଫେକ୍ଟେଡ୍, ବିକଜ୍ ଆୱାର୍ ସୋଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଆୱାର୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଆର୍ ଭେରି ଷ୍ଟ୍ରଙ୍ଗ୍। ସୋ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ମୋରାଲ୍ ୱିପନ୍, ଦି ସତ୍ୟାଗ୍ରହ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ମୋରାଲ୍ ୱିପନ୍ ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଇଭିଲ୍, ଇନ୍ଜଷ୍ଟିସ୍, ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲୋଇଟେସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅନ୍ଟ୍ରୁଥଫୁଲନେସ୍। ନେକ୍ସଟ ଆସ୍ପେକ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ପେସିଭ୍ ରେଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ଇଜ୍ ନନ୍ କୋଅପରେସନ୍। ନା, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ମିନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡିଂ ସଫରିଂ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲୋଇଟେସନ୍, ନନ୍ କୋଅପରେସନ୍। ତା ମାନେ ଇଫ୍ ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ନଟ୍ କୋଅପରେଟ୍, ଦେନ୍ ଏନି ଇନ୍ଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ନଟ୍ ରନ୍ ୱିଦାଉଟ୍ କୋଅପରେସନ୍। ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ରିମେମ୍ବର ୟୁ ନୋ ଫଙ୍କସନାଲିଜିମ୍, ଫଙ୍କସନାଲିଷ୍ଟ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଦ ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ଇନ୍ଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍ ଲାଇଜ୍ ଇନ୍ ଇଟ୍ସ ଫଙ୍କସନିଂ। ଇଫ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଷ୍ଟପ୍ ଫଙ୍କସନିଂ, ଦେନ୍ ନୋ ଫଙ୍କସନିଂ, ନୋ ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ। ସୋ ଲାଇକ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଫ୍ ୱି ୱିଲ୍ ଷ୍ଟପ୍ କୋଅପରେଟିଂ, ୱି ୱିଲ୍ ନନ୍ କୋଅପରେଟ୍ ଦି ବ୍ରିଟିଶ, ଦେନ୍ ଦ ବ୍ରିଟିଶ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ନଟ୍ ରନ୍। ଇଫ୍ ଦି ବ୍ରିଟିଶ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ନଟ୍ ରନ୍, ଦେନ୍ ଦେ ୱିଲ୍ ବି ବାଉଣ୍ଡ ଟୁ ଷ୍ଟପ୍ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲୋଇଟେସନ୍ ଅର୍ ଟୁ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲୋଇଟେସନ୍। ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ସ ୱାଇ ଫର୍ ଗାନ୍ଧୀ ନନ୍ କୋଅପରେସନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ମିନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡିଂ ଦି ସଫରିଂ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲୋଇଟେସନ୍। ଇଫ୍ ପିପୁଲ୍ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟ ଇଟ୍ ଏଗେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ ଦି ଅନ୍ଜଷ୍ଟ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ସୁନର୍ ଅର୍ ଲେଟର୍ ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ କମ୍ ଟୁ ଏନ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ବେଣ୍ଡ ଦି ଆବ୍ସଲ୍ୟୁଟ୍ ପାୱାର୍। ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ନେଚର, ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ନେଚର୍ ଅଫ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ପେସିଭ୍ ରେଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ, ଦେନ୍ ଦି ମିନ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏଣ୍ଡ। ଫର୍ ଗାନ୍ଧୀ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ସେଇଙ୍ଗ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ସୁଡ୍ ଲିଡ୍ ଟୁ ଦି ରାଇଟ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ। ସୋ ଫର୍ ଗାନ୍ଧୀ ସେ କହୁଥିଲେ ଏଣ୍ଡ ବି ଗୁଡ୍ ହବା ଦରକାର, ଆଉ ମିନ୍ ବି ଗୁଡ୍ ହବା ଦରକାର। ଇଫ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଇଜ୍ ଗୁଡ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ମିନ୍ସ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଗୁଡ୍, ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ମେ ଲିଡ୍ ଟୁ ଦି କରପ୍ସନ୍, ଇଟ୍ ମେ ଲିଡ୍ ଟୁ ଦି ମୋରାଲ୍ ଡିଗ୍ରେଡେସନ୍, ଡିଜେନେରେସନ୍ ୱିଦିନ୍ ଦି ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ୍। ସୋ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟେଜି ଅଫ୍ ପେସିଭ୍ ରେଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଗାନ୍ଧୀ। passive resistance is one kind of social movement. Then the other social movement, what I am interested to discuss with you, that is Chantal Mouffe radical democracy, right? For Chantal Mouffe, the radicalization of democracy resistance goes beyond the opposition to a particular kind of domination, to the opposition to the whole structure of domination. This needs a discursively constructed resistance. Right? Tike Bujinova, Chantal Mouffe, Tankar Jo radical democracy, say radical democracy, say ego tha kochanti. I will read. These are very important points I have prepared, but I'm oriented. Radical democracy, how radical democracy is a kind of social movement. Chantal Mouffe, it attacks the foundationalist approach of liberalism and essential character of Marxism. What is the foundationalist nature of liberalism? Consensus can be possible. And now here Chantal Mouffe is saying that now consensus possible nuha. When you are even in the deliberative democracy also, when you are coming towards a conclusion, then you are marginalizing the view of minority. Democracy is not all about marginalization. Democracy is all about, you know, giving due share to that one individual. 99 individual can be wrong, one individual can be right. So that one individual should not be marginalized. The voice of that one individual should be heard. The majority should not impose their decision over the minority. If you are doing, then you are not understanding the political. Political per se means it is conflictual. And democracy without political is not not democracy. So for Chantal Mouffe, a radical democratic pluralism, it opposes to all forms of domination. It seeks condition for free individual and self-development. It requires the elimination of oppression and exploitation. It accepts the legitimacy of democratic differences. Diversity kebala tume externally fight karibani. तुमको डाइवर्सिटा इंटरनली भी मेंटेन करिबा पई पड़िबो। तुम्हें कहिबो कि नहीं मु तुम ठारु अलगा, किंतु तुम भितर जो डिफरेंसेस कुडा अछि, आर यू एड्रेसिंग दैट डिफरेंसेस और यू आर जस्ट इम्पोजिंग योर यू नो होमोजेनिटी ऑन दोज डिफरेंसेस। तनु रेडिकल प्लुरलिज्म एड्रेस दोज डिफरेंसेस इन ग्रुप एंड आउट ग्रुप differences that inter and intra, inter differences and intra differences. Now radical democracy retrieve the liberal democratic principle such as freedom and equality. The projection of radical democracy contrasts the deliberative democracy. Liberal democracy is not able to give a sufficient understanding of the task of democracy because it believes in making consensus over adversarial claims within the society. Now, deliberative democracy, say kebebi eta belief karuni ki consensus ku ame built up kori pariba. Ama bhitre jo adversarial claim achi, ame gote unanimity ame ani pariba. Se kochi it is not possible. Deliberative democracy attempts to avoid the tension between the democracy and liberalism. Ati democracy mane kon? Democracy means taking decision. Liberalism means protecting the liberty of individual. Now, if you protect liberty of all individual, then decision cannot be possible. Jodi bhi tumhe forcibly gote kichi decision naucha, tebe se decision ta at the cost of marginalization of some. At the cost of marginalization of minority group, that one individual. So any conception of democracy has to recognize the ever-present conflictuality and unattainability of fully inclusive agreement through rational deliberation. Radical democracy mana kar douchi, Chantal Mouffe mana kar douchi. କି ଏଟା ପସିବୁଲ ନୁହଁ। ତମେ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ କୁ ତମେ ତମେ ଯଦି କୌଣସି ଡିସିସନ ନଉଛ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଆଡ୍ରେସିଂ ଦି କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହ୍ୱେନ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଆଡ୍ରେସିଂ ଦି କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ନଟ୍ ଆଡ୍ରେସିଂ ଦି ଡେମୋକ୍ରେସି you are not understanding the concept political you are from you know totalitarian government or absolute government thus the stress on consensus has to be avoided and the inability of arriving at the final rational consensus in a pluralist society needs to be acknowledged the possibility of consensus is the result of a provisional hegemony and it always assures a kind of exclusion jong jinsata ame mu passive revolution le mu kahitili ki sethi gote prakar re hegemony operate kare sethi integration kichhi na thae sei jinsata chental mophi bi kahuchanti karan chental mophi is you know chental mophi is a gramscian thinker Chantal Mophi Chantal Mophi he tries to you know understand the radical democracy taking the help from the Gramscian philosophy also to her Chantal Mophi he is not a he actually see is a lady Chantal Mophi so denial of antagonism and assertion of democracy is mere sphere of rational consensus and deliberation process is the negation of the very nature of political as I said if democracy is all about taking decision taking rational decision then the deliberation but the negation of the very nature of political so grasping the nature of political is the main task of you know radical democracy ontological understanding of political in its antagonistic nature can confront the claim of superior rational consensus of liberal democracy तेणु एटी चेंतल मफी जो लिबरल डेमोक्रेसी डेलीवरेटिव डेमोक्रेसी से कहते कनसेनसस इज पॉसिबल से रुथलेसली चैलेंज करते कहते जदि तुम्हें कनसेनस पाखे पहुँचुच देन तुम्हें एक्चुअली डेमोक्रेटिक नुह तुम एटा को इम्पोज करुच तुम्हें तुम हेजिमोनी को अन्य उपरे इम्पोज करुच तुम्हें एंटागोनिज्म ह्यूमन बिहेवियर जो एंटागोनिस्टिक एटीच्यूड अच्छी से एंटागोनिस्टिक एटीच्यूड को तुम बुझुना so it is a kind of imposition khali chantal mophi liberal democracy ko attack karinanti even at the same time chantal mophi provides for a new conception of left that goes beyond the essentialist as well as foundationalist characteristic of marxism socialist democracy based on classical marxism is unable to understand the meaning of new struggle and new movement ता माने से कहउचंती इवन मार्क्सिज्म भी कंसेंसस को ही बिलीव करुच मार्क्सिज्म भी यूनिवर्सल क्लेम को बिलीव करुच मार्क्सिज्म भी पॉलिटिकल को बुझुनी तेणु एठी यू नो लिबरल डेमोक्रेसी भी बुझुनी एठी फासिज्म फासिस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट से भी बुझुनी एठी कम्युनिस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट से माने भी जो आमर अच्छी से माने भी दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड दैट एंटागोनिस्टिक नेचर ऑफ पॉलिटिकल दैट कंसेंसस इज नॉट पॉसिबल सो एवरी कंसेंसस इज बेस्ड ऑन सर्टेन एक्ट्स ऑफ एक्सक्लूजन एंड फुल्ली इंक्लूसिव रेशनल कंसेंसस इज इम्पॉसिबल टू अराइव एट सो देर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द पॉलिटिकल एंड पॉलिटिक्स While political concerns about antagonistic dimension, politics informs the idea of some of institution and practices that aims at the establishment of a certain order, a sphere of political always influence the sphere of political always influence the politics. You know, political politics with a difference. Politics talks about consensus. Politics talks about you know establishing a certain order politics all about universalization but political is all about you know understanding the antagonistic dimension the sphere of political always influences the politics. Tamane, if you want to establish a order, that order must not be based on the marginalization of that one individual or marginalization of some. So politics must be influenced by political. If you are avoiding the political, if you are not dealing with political, then you are not establishing the right politics. Negation of political leads to incapability of politics to confront different forms of exclusion and inclusion. Tamane, amar jo social movement, ame jodi sei political aspect ku deal na kariba, then we may not arrive at the right politics. Tamane, ame amar social movement ku durbal kar daba. Jounta state karuchi, joun state kute joun homogeneity anuchi amo upare impose karuchi, jodi social movement bi sei prakar ra homogeneity tar internal structure re adopt kare, tebe social movement while fighting that social movement is making itself very weak. I mean, passive resistance weak hai jiba, anti-passive revolution weak hai jiba, active revolution weak hai jiba. Ketabale active revolution strong hava? Now only when you address the question of political while dealing with politics. The myth of coercion free dialogue has to be abandoned. Tamane, যে আমি যখন কহুছে কি উই ক্যান এভয়েড কোর্জন, উই ক্যান বিল্ড আপ কনসেনসাস, উই ক্যান হ্যাভ এ ফ্রি ডায়লগ, উই ক্যান ডেলিভারেট, নাও ইট ইজ নট পসিবল, ইট ইজ নট এট অল পসিবল টু 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 হ্যাভ এ কোর্জন ফ্রি ডায়লগ। হ্যান্স দিস কনসেপ্ট, অল দিস কনসেপ্ট অফ কনসেনসাস বাই বোথ মার্কসিস্ট অ্যান্ড লিবরাল হ্যাজ টু বি অ্যাবান্ডন্ড। So there is a requirement of alternative approach which would acknowledge that power is constitutive of every relation within the society. Ta mane amku there is a requirement of alternative approach. Alternative approach ta kon aba na, it will acknowledge, so alternative approach acknowledge karibo ki power is the constitutive of every relationship within society. সোসাইটির প্রতিটি ইন স্পিয়ার পাওয়ার আছে, আর প্রত্যেক পাওয়ার কু আমি এড্রেস করা পড়ব। আমি স্টেট পাওয়ার কু বেশি গুরুত্ব দেবা, অন্য সব পাওয়ার কু আমি গুরুত্ব দেবানি, সেটা রেডিকাল ডেমোক্রেসি মনা করছে। তেমন যে সোশিয়াল মুভমেন্ট হব, সে সোশিয়াল মুভমেন্ট স্টেট কু, স্টেটর পাওয়ার কু বেশি ইম্পর্টেন্স দেবানি, রেদর দেন ইট উইল গিভ ইম্পর্টেন্স টু ডিফারেন্ট কাইন্ডস অফ পাওয়ার ইন এ প্লুরাল সোসাইটি। দেয়ার আর ডিফারেন্ট ইনস্টিটিউশন ইন এ প্লুরাল সোসাইটি, and different institution has different power, and the radical democracy has it wants social movements to give importance to those power of different institution in a pluralist society. The Marxist concept of a materialist history and the notion of communist society as harmonious is not capable of grasping the nature of political, that is a clearly mentioned karchi. Marxists have failed Marx. রেডিকাল ডেমোক্রেসি চন্তন মফি কোথায় কন না, মার্কসিস্ট হেজ ফেলড মার্কস, সেই সেন্সরে আমি কহিপারিবা, টিকে যদি চিন্তা করি ভাবিব, আম্বেদকর হেজ ফেলড, আম্বেদকর রাইট হেজ ফেলড আম্বেদকর, গান্ধিয়ান হেজ ফেলড গান্ধী। না উই নিড টু ইউ নো ইভালুয়েট অল দিস স্টেটমেন্ট, আই মে বি রং, মে বি ইউ অল হ্যাভ পাসড মার্কসিস্ট হেজ পাসড মার্কস, আম্বেদকর রাইট হেজ পাসড আম্বেদকর, গান্ধিয়ান হেজ পাসড গান্ধী, বট আর উই, what is the rate of our success? Have we achieved something? What Ambedkar has dreamed, what Gandhi has dreamed, what Marx has dreamed? So Chantal Mafia clearly says, Marxist has failed Marx by saying a permanent eradicability of the antagonism. No, antagonism is not possible. Antagonism will be there. In fact, in the communist society, presence of antagonism does not play a significant role. Tamane eti se kahuchi, even communist society re bi semane antagonism ku suppress kar douchan, diversity ku suppress kar douchan, liberal democracy re consensus na re diversity ku suppress kar douchi, fascism na re ডাইভরসিটি কু সপ্রেস করা যাচ্ছে, যেটি ডাইভরসিটি কু সপ্রেস করা যাচ্ছে, যেটি অ্যান্টাগোনিজম অপোজিশন কু সপ্রেস করা যাচ্ছে, সেটি ডেমোক্রেসি পসিবল নহ, କାହିଁକି ଡେମୋକ୍ରାସି ପସିବୁଲ ନୁହଁ ନା? ସେଠି ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଯାହା କାମ କରୁଛି, ସେଠି ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ସେଇ କାମ କରୁଛି, ସେଠି ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲିଷ୍ଟ ସେଇ କାମ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ସେଠି ସେକୁଲାରିଷ୍ଟ ସେଇ କାମ କରୁଛି, ସେଠି ସୋସିଆଲ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ବି ସେଇ କାମ କରୁଛି। କୋଉଠି ନା କୋଉଠି ୱି ଆର୍ ଜଷ୍ଟ ମିୟର ଇମେଜ ଟୁ ଇଚ୍ ଅଦର। ତେଣୁ ଯଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟର ନେଚର ଯାହା ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲିଷ୍ଟ ସୋସିଆଲ ଜଷ୍ଟିସ ପାର୍ଟି ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଟି ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ ପାର୍ଟି ଦେନ୍ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ସୋସିଆଲ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଏମାନେ ମାନେ ମୁଁ ରେସନାଲ ରେସନାଲ କହୁନି, ଇ ମିନ୍ ଦ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟେଜି ଦ ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଆଡପ୍ଟ ଦ ମେଥଡୋଲୋଜି ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଆଡପ୍ଟ ୟୁ ମଷ୍ଟ ଆଡପ୍ଟ ଦ ଅପୋଜିଟ୍ ମେଥଡୋଲୋଜି ଇନ୍ ଅର୍ଡର ଟୁ ଚ୍ୟାଲେଞ୍ଜ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ। ମୋର ବହୁତ ଗୁଡ଼ା ଜିନିଷରେ ଦେଖାଯାଉଛି, ଆଇ ଟକ୍ ଟୁ ଇଟ୍ ପ୍ରଫେସର ପଟ୍ଟନାୟକ ଆଣ୍ଡ ୱି ଆର୍ ଇନ୍ ରେଗୁଲାର ଟକ୍ ଫ୍ରମ ହିଜ୍ ଓନ୍ ଏକ୍ସପର୍ଟାଇଜ ହି ଟେଲ୍ସ ମି ଦ୍ୟାଟ କୋଉଠି ନା କୋଉଠି ଅଲ୍ ଦିଜ୍ ଫେଲ୍ସ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ବିକଜ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଇନହେରେଣ୍ଟିଂ ସର୍ଟେନ୍ ଟେଣ୍ଡେନ୍ସି ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ୱେନ୍ ୟୁ ଇନହେରେଣ୍ଟ ସର୍ଟେନ୍ ଟେଣ୍ଡେନ୍ସି ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ବିକମ୍ସ ଭେରି ଇଜି ଫର୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଟୁ ଡିସମାଣ୍ଟଲ ୟୋର ସୋସିଆଲ ମୁଭମେଣ୍ଟ ଅର୍ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି। ସୋ ଏଜ୍ ଦି ଏଲିମିନେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଆଣ୍ଟାଗୋନିଜିମ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଇମ୍ପସିବୁଲ ଦ ଗୋଲ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ପ୍ଲୁରାଲିଷ୍ଟ ଡେମୋକ୍ରାସି ଇଜ୍ ଟୁ କନ୍ଷ୍ଟିଟ୍ୟୁଟ୍ ଡିଫରେନ୍ସ କେପାବିଲିଟି ଡିଫରେନ୍ସ compatible with democratic I'm repeating, as the elimination of antagonism is impossible, the goal of pluralist democracy is to constitute difference compatible with democratic values. This difference will bring brings antagonistic pluralism to deliver the amaro radical democracy ra the key concept is antagonistic pluralism। Which conceive an articulation of us and them in a way that they no longer perceive as enemy of mutual destruction but competing adversarial parties. The category adversary informs the presence of groups fighting against each other but not negating the legitimacy of opponent. One cannot combat with others idea but others right to defend their idea has to prevail. This confrontation of adversary is the base of vibrant democracy. Tamane se kon kahuchi, we are not enemy, we are adversary. I may not agree with you but you have every right to put your point and I have every right to disagree with you. Now this is, if this things happen that we are not enemy, minority is not the enemy of majority, majority is not the enemy of minority, if such thing will happen then you are making our democracy vibrant. This is the radical democracy, to radicalize the notion of pluralism, denouncement of rationalism, universalism, individualism becomes unavoidable. Ta mane mu jaha kahuchu thik anya jane pura bhul kahuchu seita ko avoid kariya pai padibo। ମେ ବି ଅନ୍ୟ ଜଣେ ଯାହା କହୁଛି, ମୁଁ ଯାହା କହୁଛି, ତା ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ସିମିଲାରିଟି ଅଛି। ଆମେ ଯଦି ଡିପର ସେନ୍ସକୁ ଯିବା ସେ ସିମିଲାରିଟିଟା ଆମେ ପାଇବା। ତେଣୁ ଆମେ ଯେଉଁ ଗୋଟେ ୟୁନିଭର୍ସାଲ କ୍ଲେମ୍ କରିଦଉଛେ, ଲେଫ୍ଟ କହୁଛି ମୁଁ ଠିକ, ରାଇଟ୍ କହୁଛି ମୁଁ ଠିକ, କଂଗ୍ରେସ କହୁଛି ମୁଁ ଠିକ, ରିପବ୍ଲିକ କହୁଛି ମୁଁ ଠିକ, ଏନ୍ଡିଟିଭି କହୁଛି ମୁଁ ଠିକ, ନା ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ଦି ଡାଇଲେକ୍ଟିକ୍ସ and you all don't understand that that radical democracy rejects your rationalism, rejects your universalism, rejects your individualism. If you reject, then only you can find in each other, then only social movement can be successful fighting against oppression done by the state. So thank you very much।
ଅନ୍ତର୍ଜାମି ସାର୍, ପ୍ଲିଜ୍ ଟେକ୍ ଓଭର। Antarjami sir.
Bigness, ये हमारा अंतर्जाम ही गले कुआडे
किसी प्रॉब्लम अच्छी किसी टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम अच्छी सर फिर जन बैक करते हैं सर शॉर्टली
अच्छा आई आई टुक टू मच एक्चुअली इट बिकम्स वेरी थियोरेटिकल राइट सो विदाउट अंडरस्टैंडिंग द थ्योरी you know, any description or practice, it will not be fruitful actually. There are certain theoretical flaws, and I'm very much interested in the theoretical aspect of civil society and social movement.
Right, sir.
So if there are any questions, I can take 4 or 5 questions.
Definitely, sir. Right, sir. You have already 10 or 15 questions. From the learner side, and we'll discuss it one by one.
Yes.
Okay, sir. The first question is, what is the relationship between civil society and welfare state? A question from Baby Roy.
And it's okay. Don't mention the name of
right,
that
sir.
Candidate. You just repeat the question. I'm writing writing the question.
What is the
what
relationship
is?
Between?
All right.
Okay, sir. Sir, answer, sir. Take over.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You are audible.
Yes.
Yes, yes. Hello, Dr. Himanshu, sir, Mr. Sir. Okay,
yes.
Okay. Now I'm joining the meeting because there are some technical problem with my internet. So thank you so much, Dr. Himanshu Sagar, Mr. Sir. You have well elaborated the concept of civil society and social movement. You defined civil society and social movement categorically. You also touch upon the Marxist approach on civil society, particularly G.W.F. Hegel concept of civil society and the Gramsci concept of civil society. You also talk about the how social movement and how civil society is interlinked with each other, like they have separate thing, but still the relevance of civil society to contextualize the social movement is so relevant in the contemporary time. Particularly, you give the example of Gandhian approach to deals with the civil social movement, particularly on its four principles like truth, nonviolence, satyagraha, and versus resistance, truth, nonviolence, satyagraha, and non-cooperation. So this type of idea will provide a broader sense to the student of political science to think and critically think upon the role of civil society in the context of social movement. Now we can take some questions, sir. So I'm reading the question and you put you can write
yes.
it or you can answer one by one. No problem.
I am writing the question, so you bit slow. Yes, what is the relationship between
all right, so no problem, civil
yes.
society and welfare state. The second question is, can businesses, business organizations be called as civil society? Hello, sir.
I'm just writing. Give me 1 minute.
Business organizations.
Organize. Can business be called
all right.
civil society? Yeah, it's okay.
So civil society. The third question is basically two questions. You can put in one question. This is the what is the relevance of civil society in the 21st century or in the contemporary era? Put it in the one question, sir.
what is the relevance of civil society today?
What is the role of civil society for underprivileged section of the society? No, sir.
Civil society for underprivileged section.
Hello.
Yes.
Underprivileged section of the society. Sir, we'll take five.
Underprivileged section. Yes.
Okay. Then section. The final question is the last question is. Is the current capitalist is the current capitalist class or the
Is the current capitalist class?
Carry on, sir.
Is the last question is the current capitalist class?
Are the part of
what is the last question
of the civil society?
Is the current
the
capitalist class? Passive revolution?
The current capitalist class
are
the part of passive revolutions of the civil society. Civil society.
Okay. So these are the five questions. So let me deal one by one.
Yes, sir.
So
yes.
What is the relationship between the civil society and yes, Antariyami? What is the relationship between the civil society and welfare state? Very straightforward. Now, the goal of civil society is to establish a welfare state. And a welfare state is a state where you will find that the coexistence of liberty and equality. Here, liberty basically means let the individual free. Liberty basically means development, economic development. And here equality means adopting certain socialist principles or ame koi pariba social justice. Tenu welfare state re ame dekhuche economic development au amara social justice ra gote combo. A welfare state is a state where you will find both there is economic development and there is also social justice. Now, civil society ro kama kono mane how to establish a welfare state by the civil society. Now, amara mostly dekha jauchi ki state always associated with the economic development, economic aspect. Now, civil society it gives importance to the social justice. Tanu jetebe se state ko challenge korchi civil society. And the civil society is maintaining certain values of social justice, then state sati compromise kariba pai state ko compromise kariba pai paduchi out civil society beti compromise karuchi tanu civil society 100% social justice ko follow karuchi state 100% development ko follow karuchi then in between jo compromise hochi se compromise re development bhi rahuchi social justice bhi rahuchi jo to ame kahuche gote welfare state then civil society and welfare state with re link hochi kana na civil society is a contributor of welfare state civil society re state bhi contribute karuchi welfare state ko welfare state re there is a contribution from the state there is a contribution from the civil society state ra contribution kon na economic development civil society contribution kon na social justice and that's the relationship between the civil society and the welfare state and the second question is that can business organization be called a civil society jodi eta tumhe hegel ko pacharibo hegel ko pacharle se kahibe yes for hegel civil society is negative for hegel as I said that middle class commercial society is the civil society and what is this middle class commercial society that what we mean by business organization now for hegel this business organization are civil society but jodi ame hegel ko jodi ame gramsci ko pachari bai prashna now gramsci will say that sorry business organization cannot be the civil society because civil society dita character rahibo kon character rahibo na civil society taro ethical aur moral aspect rahibo ethical aur moral aur tumhe jetale business ଯେତେବେଳେ ତୁମେ ବିଜନେସ କ୍ଲାସ କଥା କହୁଛ ସେତେବେଳେ ଟୁ ହ୍ୱାଟ ଏକ୍ସଟେଣ୍ଟ ୟୁ ଆର ଥିଙ୍କିଂ ଏବାଉଟ ଏଥିକ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ମୋରାଲିଟି ବିଜନେସ ଇଜ ଅଲ୍ ଏବାଉଟ ୟୁ ନୋ ଏକୁମୁଲେଟିଂ ୱେଲ୍ଥ ବିଜନେସ ଇଜ ଅଲ୍ ଏବାଉଟ କ୍ରିଏଟିଂ ସରପ୍ଲସ୍ ତେଣୁ ଗ୍ରାମସିକୁ ଯଦି ପଚରାଯିବ ହ୍ୱେଦର ବିଜନେସ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ ଆର୍ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଅର୍ ନଟ୍ ଗ୍ରାମସି ମନା କରିଦେବେ ଗ୍ରାମସି କହିବେ ନୋ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଦି ବିଜନେସ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ ଦେନ୍ ଦି ଥାର୍ଡ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ ହ୍ୱାଟ ଇଜ ଦି ରୋଲ ଅଫ ଦି ରେଲିଭାନ୍ସ ଅଫ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଟୁଡେ the role of or the relevance of civil society today is that as I said in the last class when social justice becomes the victim of its own success and civil society tries to protect or contribute to the welfare state in the forms of social justice then I think the role of civil society today it is or it should be much more than earlier. I mean, aji ame multiple problems kura dekhuche, jodi ame Chantal Mofira radical democracy ko mone pakeiba, tabe ame dekhuche gote prakar ro antagonism develop karuchi, gote prakar ro, you know, enmity develop karuchi, loko nijuku prosper ko accept karunanti, loko mane gote prakar ro universal claim karuchanti, right? Eta Chantal Mofi kotha guda kahuchanti, and individuals, they don't understand the nature of political, hence, they are actually going against democracy while protecting the democracy tanu ei situation le mate laguchi civil society ro relevance ba civil society ro low role tike larger achi civil society gote civil society will act like you know ice break civil society to should dismantle all kinds of essentialism what we have civil society should adopt a conflict resolution method. Civil society should understand what are the binaries. Civil society should go beyond the binary and civil society tries to think about the dialectical relationship to different extreme. Whether it is Gandhi or Ambedkar, I mean Gandhi and Ambedkar both are not different. There are also, you know, there are also certain commonalities. So without that, conflict cannot be solved. ତେଣୁ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟିର ରେଲିଭାନ୍ସ କ'ଣ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଏଇ ଜିନିଷଟାକୁ ଆଇ ମିନ୍ ପରିଶୁ ତାକୁ କରିବାର ଅଛି ଆଉ ମୋତେ ଲାଗୁଛି ଏବେ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟିର ରୋଲ୍ ଅଧିକା ଅଛି ମାନେ ଯେବେ ଯେବେ କ୍ରାଇସିସ୍ ଅଧିକା ବଢ଼ୁଛି ସେବେ ସେବେ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ର ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାନ୍ସ ବି ବଢ଼ୁଛି ଆମେ ଯଦି ୱାର୍ ଆଉ ଡିପ୍ଲୋମାସି ମେଟାଫର୍ରେ କହିବା ନା ହ୍ୱେନ୍ ୱାର୍ ବିଗିନ୍ସ ଡିପ୍ଲୋମାସି ଫେଲ୍ but when war begins diplomacy becomes the need then no doubt civil society fail karichi civil society has failed and that's why such a situation has been arisen but in such a situation it is the civil society that can offer the solution if you don't have civil society then problem ahuri aggravated heijibo then civil society ko tar nijara chetana ko jagrat karaiba pai padibo ଆଉ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଡାଇଲଗ ଆଉ ଡିସ୍କସନ ମାଧ୍ୟମରେ ଗୋଟେ କଥାକୁ ସଲ୍ଭ କରାଇବା ପାଇଁ ପଡିବ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟିକୁ ୟୁନୋ ଇକୋନୋମିକ ଦେଖିବା ପାଇଁ ପଡିବ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟିକୁ ଏଥିକ୍ସ ଆଉ ମୋରାଲିଟିକୁ ବି ଦେଖିବା ପାଇଁ ପଡିବ ଦୁଇଟା ଜିନିଷକୁ ଦେଖିବା ପାଇଁ ପଡିବ ଦି ଫୋର୍ଥ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଦ ରୋଲ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସିଭିଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଫର୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ ଇଜ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଫୋର୍ଥ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ଅନ୍ତର୍ଜମୀ Hello. Okay. So the fourth question is that what is the role of civil society for underdeprived section?
Yes, sir. Got it.
What is the role of civil society for underprivileged section? Now the role of civil society is nothing but empowering social movements. And these social movements are nothing but anti-passive revolution. And this anti-passive revolution or active revolution, what Gandhi calls the passive resistance, is nothing but safeguarding the rights of deprived section, safeguarding the right of underprivileged section, safeguarding the rights of powerless individual. Gandhi ko pai powerless hochanti freedom fighter, aw amaro Marx ko pai powerless hochanti have nots category. But then we have to identify there are different kinds of deprived section mu eta barambar tumko kahuchi ki marginalization gote prakar ra nuho right there are different kinds of marginalization achi different kinds of deprived section ଅଛି ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ବେସିସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ସେକ୍ସନ୍ ଅଛି ତେଣୁ ଆମକୁ ଆମର ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି କେବଳ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାର ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ସେକ୍ସନ୍କୁ ଡିଲ୍ ନ କରିକି ଯଦି ସେ ବିଭିନ୍ନ ପ୍ରକାର ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ସେକ୍ସନ୍ କୁ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଇ କରିବ ଆଉ ତାର ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍କୁ ଡିଲ୍ କରିବ ଦେନ୍ ମୋତେ ଲାଗୁଛି ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ବିକମ୍ ଏ ମାର୍ଚ୍ଚ ଅଫ୍ ଗଡ୍ ଅନ୍ ଦି ଆର୍ଥ ଯେଉଁଟାକୁ ମୁଁ କହୁଛି ୟଦା ୟଦା ଧର୍ମେଶ୍ୟ ଯେଉଁଟା ଅଛି ମୋତେ ଲାଗୁଛି ଯଦି ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ଏଇ କାମ କରିପାରିବ ଦେନ୍ ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଇନକର୍ନେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ଲର୍ଡ କ୍ରିଷ୍ଣା ଅନ୍ ଦି ଆର୍ଥ ତେଣୁ ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟିର ଲାର୍ଜର କାମ ଅଛି ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ମଲ୍ଟିପୁଲ୍ ମାର୍ଜିନାଲାଇଜେସନ୍କୁ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଇ କରିବା ତା ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍କୁ ଆଡ୍ରେସ୍ କରିବା ଲୋକଙ୍କୁ ୟୁ ନୋ ପଲିଟିକାଲ୍ କନସେପ୍ଟ ସହିତ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଇ କରାଇବା ଯଦି ଏସବୁ କାମ କରୁଛି ଦେନ୍ ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ସେ ସିଭିଲ୍ ସୋସାଇଟି ଜୟ ହୋ Then the fifth question is that, what is the fifth question, Antaryami? Is the current capitalist class are the part of passive revolution of civil society?
Yes, sir, I'm
ready.
Sorry,
this question is a wrong question.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
This question is straightforwardly, it is a wrong question.
Sir, yes.
What is the wrong in it? Because civil society has nothing to do with the passive revolution. Civil society is always against the passive revolution. Civil society is for active revolution. Civil society is for the passive resistance. So since this question is a wrong question, but let me mean is that is the current capitalist class are the part of passive revolution? Of civil society, you cut it. That's a correct question. Of civil society, you cut it. That's a set of abhishek nahi se part. For me, yes, always the current capitalist system are the part of passive revolution. The capitalist Stalin bhi gote sense ra ame eti capitalism ko alga sense re bujhibar ach. Even communism ra Stalin se bhi gote prakar ra capitalist thila. Se tar capital kon thila na tar capital thila power, influence. Tar capital thila Vanguard party, communist. Tar capital kon thila na he knows what is the conscience of proletariat class then capital kebal money ko bujhaini there are different you know meaning of capitals then yes current capitalist class pai passive revolution ta they are always part of the passive revolution it is the passive revolution that make them elite right so thank you antar jame
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Dr. Hima. Thank you, Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra, sir, for your like elaborate the concept broadly with clear vision, with clear idea to the student, to the learner. So this is the time I would say to thank you particularly to give your time in this rain and everything in the last night. You told me in the morning that there is less chance of taking class for today's session, but finally you made it, and I am happy. And the university will like glad you finally made the class possible. So on behalf of Odisha State Open University, I would like to thank you, and thank you for your time, thank you for your idea, thank you for your insightful thought to the concept of civil society and social movement. And hopefully we'll be arranging more class for you, as you mentioned, for arrange the class on ethnicity. So sir, can I consider 12 in the morning for the class? Is that fine?
12 on which day, man? Kaun dina seta poduchi?
12 is the morning. It is the Monday, sir.
Monday. Put it on
the
Monday.
No, sir. Tuesday, sir. Tuesday. Sir, it is Tuesday, sir.
It's okay.
Is that fine, sir?
No problem. Tuesday? Yeah. Yes. Okay. I agree with that.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. On behalf of Odisha State Open University, we'll be in touch with you for more classes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. And you are most welcome also. Okay, then.